I never thought I'd be able to make this video. So I think first and foremost, let me tell you just a little bit of the backstory. In February 2020, before we even knew about a pandemic, really, I traveled over to Italy because I have always wanted to buy a house in Italy. It was kind of like one of those dreams that I had even when I was much younger. And I wanted to make the dream a reality. So I decided to look in Northern Tuscany. So when the estate agent showed me this house in February 2020, after I had looked at probably about a dozen, I knew that this was the one. I wanted something that was livable, so it wasn't a complete wreck, so that I would be able to live here while the restorations were going on, or at least as much as possible. Two bedroom, one bath, well, at least what I thought was one bath, kitchen, sitting room, and that lovely terrace up above. I mean, I think that's probably what sold it for me, was the terrace and the bells. However, I get back to England and lo and behold, not only did sort of the pandemic take over, but Italy, you know, was really, really massively affected. First, it was the, you know, big country on the mainland that was affected with COVID first. So I put in my offer was accepted, and then boom, everything, the entire world started to close down slowly but surely. But of course, Italy was first. But lo and behold, November 29th, 2020. I still haven't seen my little Italian house since that first viewing in February. I got the keys virtually through the screen because it was all done. The deed was done. The house was mine. But when I was finally able to travel here with all the COVID paperwork that you needed back in those days to travel and my mask fully on, I arrived. I could not wait to see the house. But what was absolutely astonishing was what I discovered when I arrived. So as I walked up the stairs, I peered into this door that had been closed shut when I was there for my viewing in February. It was closed shut, and I think they said it was just like an owner's closet. But the door was open. Of course, it was unlocked. It's my house now. And I see that it was clearly a shower room, that there was plumbing there. And that made me smile from ear to ear because I realized, oh my goodness, I can have to lose. The big bathroom had this sort of slightly horrible shower. I don't even know how to describe it. Hardly any water came out. There wasn't a screen. You just sort of stepped onto a platform. That was my first big project, but at the same time, I knew I wanted to do something with that second loo room, if you like, now it's a utility room. And we thought together, Malcolm and I, that the best thing to do was to, within the big bathroom, was to not only have a bath, but also to knock through a wall and create the shower that actually was there in the next door room. So we broke through the wall, got rid of all the tile on the walls, and we decided we'll put two loos, well, a loo in the utility room, make that sort of laundry, utility, storage, and then have a huge bathroom with a bath. And I found the bathtub. It's reclaimed sort of on the side of a road of a antique shop. I love it. And then just choosing bits of upcycled bits and objects that I found. So the mirror in the bathroom, the wall sconces on either side, found at one of my favorite flea markets here in Italy, Il Piccolo Scrigno. I want to take a second to say how grateful I am of the paid partnership of today's video, and that's BetterHelp. And I just love what they are doing. Living the lifestyle that I do, where I'm moving from one project to the next, and I'm literally spinning so many plates all at once. And there are a lot of highs that you guys see, but there's also plenty of lows as well, which has had a massive impact on my mental health over the years. My life can just be so overwhelming at times, and I've suffered from burnout in the past, especially after the pandemic, when life just got really, really tough for me. Yet I want to achieve so much in the time that I have on this planet. But in order to do that, I need to take care of my mental health, just like I'm taking care of my physical health with yoga. And I just want to remind you guys that, you know, if you're struggling, and so many people are, there is so much shown on social media. Like, it's like the highlights of people's lives. And remember, that's just a snippet. So don't let that fool you. You're not alone in your struggles. So if you're having a hard time, or you're feeling pressure, you're feeling low, or you're just feeling burnt out, please do talk to someone, whether that's a friend or a family member, or you might be interested in taking up therapy like I have. BetterHelp helps you connect with a credentialed therapist who's trained to listen and give unbiased advice. You just go to their site, you can use my link, it's betterhelp.com/AmericanViscountess, and you just need to answer a few questions. They're super simple. Then you're matched to your very own therapist, usually within 48 hours, so that is super quick. And then if you feel like down the line you need to switch your therapist, that's super easy. It's free of charge, because BetterHelp is there to make sure that you find the right fit for what you need right now. And for me, therapy online is super convenient because I can still do my many projects here and there and everywhere, but you can do it via a video, a voice call, chat, or messaging, or whatever way is convenient for you at that time. So if you'd like BetterHelp to connect you to a credentialed therapist, you can again use my link, betterhelp.com/AmericanViscountess. I've popped the link in the description down below so you can enjoy a special discount on your first month. So thanks everybody, and do please take advantage of this.
So once that project was finished, I then moved on to the two bedrooms. And it was looking at getting rid of the flooring throughout the entire first floor. And rather than getting in timber floors, which of course is what I wanted, to have real timber floors, it gets humid here. And so the advice was to not do timber floor, do timber floors, and instead do finto, so fake timber floors. The fake timber floors that I have in are just beautifully handcrafted, I love them, and they look just like wood. So we decided to do a line of paint throughout the entire first floor. So you can see in the bathroom, it's kind of an ochre color. Then in the guest bedroom, we decided to do a moss green. And then in the primary bedroom, it's kind of a mix between a rose and it's a rose and lilac mixed together. Then I was able to start to source for the furniture for both of the bedrooms. And that, can I tell you, was just so much fun. So finding the four-poster bed on salency.co.uk, which is a great online flea market, I found it in France. They shipped it here. Nestor and I put it together. The desk in the primary bedroom and the side table, the bedside table, those I found both at Il Piccolo Scrigno. Then we've got on either side of on the desk and the bedside table, there are two Murano, so Murano, Italy, where glass is just so important. And if you want to find good glass, you go to Murano. And then up above, and I've got one here as well, I found a fantastic ceiling light, chandelier, small, I would call it a very small chandelier. Again, found it at Il Piccolo Scrigno. My wardrobe was also not found at Il Piccolo Scrigno, but at Riccardo Bartel, which is near Forte di Marmi. And again, they were able to paint that for me the color that I wanted. So within the room, it's then decorated with floral prints that I found here at the antiques market in Fivizzano. And then recently, the picture above the four-poster bed I found at another of my favorite flea markets called Marie Vintage. Same with the guest bedroom. Elements in there, and in particular those two headboards I found at Il Piccolo Scrigno. The corridor, again, we carried on through that same line of paint. And again, I was able to just put in bits that I found at auction houses in London, but also here in Italy. So the picture of Florence there, I found it in an auction house in London. I had the marble table made. I found a piece of marble at Deborah and Peegee's as well. and then found an ironmonger here who was able to create the base. And the corridor rug that you see is, I found that one on Salency. Moving down the stairs, I didn't know what to do. They were sort of horrible brown. I didn't like them. I couldn't really sand them up. So I sanded a little bit with Nestor, enough just to get that sort of varnish off. And we decided to repaint it black and then use a runner to go down, which I know is very, I think it's very British. And then of course, moving into the sitting room where I am now, this needed a lot of work, but I was able to paint this sitting room myself using this really, really soft gray. Do as much as I could with cleaning the terracotta floors and of course the skirting around. And I do like the exposed stone in this room, so I thought I'll just keep the exposed stone. So the day bed, for example, I found it on Salency. It came from Paris. This sofa though is a pull-out sofa because I have four children and they bring their friends. Then just looking around the room, this marble table, I think it's fantastic, beautiful color. That came from Il Piccolo Scrigno. You have the wrought iron candle sticks and the hat stand right here, found at Il Piccolo Scrigno. Same with this side table, but the one on the right, I found that one at Salency.co.uk. So I brought these over from England and they are electric rechargeable table lamps, and I think they're just brilliant. I got these from Pookie. Before I go into the kitchen, let's just head back upstairs and go to the terrace. The terrace, again, didn't need a lot of work, but it had these four long poles where the hanging line and where I used to hang laundry there was. So I cut those off, found some really good teak furniture, put that together along with placing four olive trees upstairs on my terrace. But I love the terrace now. I found a fantastic, end table, a side table that is pushed up against the wall, and that's kind of the drinks table. Finally then, of course, and most recently, and we're talking, you know, 3 years later after I had finally bought my house, I'm coming into my fourth year and I'm like, I need to get this kitchen done. But the kitchen was of course going to be the biggest project because it's the biggest room in the house. It had so much potential and Malcolm and I really spent time thinking about what we envisioned this kitchen to be. So the kitchen, again, looking at the floor, it was that same sort of white tile that was upstairs. And you can get traditional Colto terracotta tiles, but they are uber expensive. So I decided to go for porcelain. They're beautifully, they're handmade porcelain, look like terracotta tiles. And we placed them in there in a herringbone shape. And of course in the kitchen, there were lots of areas of exposed stone. I didn't like that much exposed stone in the kitchen. So I decided to close those off. And they did a fantastic job. I've kept a couple. There's, I think, two places where there's bits of exposed stone. And again, use this, a mixture between the very, very light gray, which is in this room now, on the walls in the kitchen, and then use, create a finto batiscopa, so a fake skirting board. It's just painted on, using the darker gray that's in the corridor here in the house. Malcolm and I chose the color, so this lovely sage green. And again, we went with this sort of green. You can see there's a little bit of aqua teal in here, and we went with blue there. And the kitchen cabinets, again, I was quite particular about them. I wanted to make sure that the grain could be seen, but not so much so that it became whitewashed. And that was tricky, getting that right. But Matteo and his team did just an incredible job. The hardware that you see on the kitchen drawers and cabinets, I found in England. Those are handmade. I actually did bring them over. And then the appliances, I wanted the appliances to be really sympathetic. Of course, they need to be modern, but sympathetic to the look that I was trying to achieve. I've got an integrated dishwasher, an integrated refrigerator, lots of storage and freezer, lots of storage place. And then of course, creating that lovely curtain below the sink, which leads me onto sink, which again, I found at Il Piccolo Scrigno. Marmisto did a fantastic job in cutting it to shape. And then the same thing with the honed marble that's on the countertops and just creating just that little slight curve on the edge of the marble across the countertop so that it was exactly like the stove, because the stove came with that sort of slightly rounded edge. So it's perfect all the way across. Matteo did convince me, and he was right, in putting a natural shelf up above. I was going to paint it. He said, wait and see. And what I do with it, it's a beautiful piece of castagna, chestnut wood, and I can put all my fun flea market finds on there. And then again, the pieces that I found in there, the table, the chairs, the formaggiera, the dresser that holds now some of the plates and the glasses, all found at Il Piccolo Scrigno. And I put in another sofa. And then, of course, there's the little wrought iron table, sort of my cafe style table with two chairs. One is sort of the rattan chair that I found. Then, of course, on the other side of that is the Edwardian horsehair chair, which I will eventually recover. So I will reupholster that. Looking out onto the view, seeing the lovely cafe curtains, and then the pair of curtains. Malcolm and I chose that fabric. They hang off of a brass pole that was found in the north stable blocks. The piece of art that's hanging above the sofa in the kitchen was done by my friend Alice Watt, and she used the wonderful view and colors from the view of my terrace in order to create that abstract painting. Anyway, thank you all so much for just being incredibly supportive on this channel and through this entire journey of my little Italian house. Do check out my other channel, which is all about Italy. It's called Julie in Italy, and that's where you'll find me at these various flea markets in, of course, here in Italy, and also mainland Europe, and also in the UK, finding fun objects for me, but also for you as well. And I think that's it. I'm about to go head into the square and, of course, get my Americano. Ciao, ciao.